And we are back here on KFYO Mornings with Matt and Dave. And it is Thursday. It is 7:35. And that means one thing. The CarPro is on line one. Good morning, Jerry Reynolds.
Well, good morning, fellas. How are y'all?
Well, we're doing better than we deserve, probably. So you're driving a Subaru today. Is that right?
I am. I tell you what. I love Subarus as a whole, and I always enjoy them. I know it's not as glamorous as some of the cars I have, like the BMW 850 last week, but I tell you, these cars just continue to amaze me.
I've heard you suggest them over and over again on your show to people.
Oh, absolutely. I mean,
especially in icy conditions.
If you're in an area that gets a lot of snow and ice, there's nothing better. But, you know, the rest of America has discovered Subaru as well. And in fact, in Texas, they're extremely hot. The dealers have trouble keeping them on the lot. And they just, as the August sales result came in, Subaru's got the longest consecutive streak of sales increases in automotive history. They've gone over 70 months in a row, outdoing themselves from the same month the year before. It's almost unheard of in the industry. This is the Outback. One of their most popular, and it is an all-new 2020. They've redesigned it from, you know, top to bottom, even including a new engine. There's slight changes to the exterior. Unless you're really a Subaru fan, you won't notice it at a glance, but new headlights and taillights and that sort of thing. But the technology in this car is amazing. I'm not sure there's a safer car in America than what Subaru's putting out right now. And most of that's due to their EyeSight system. And the way it works, guys, there are two cameras mounted up high on the windshield. You can't see them from the inside, but you can see them from the outside if you look. And they'll scan the road in front of you. And if a vehicle stops in front of you, it will stop itself if you don't, you know, if you're not paying attention or whatever. If you get out of your lane, it'll put you back in your lane. And it's just crazy how well it works. Now, we're talking about a $36,000 SUV here. By today's standards, that's not expensive. But check this out. When you sit down in the car, there's a facial recognition scan that comes from the dash. And once it recognizes you, which takes literally less than 2 seconds, then it changes all the settings in the car. It adjusts your seat. It adjusts your mirrors. The whole thing. And I mean, it's just space-age stuff here. And you can store up to 5 people. So whoever gets behind the wheel, if they are in the system and the car knows your face, it will make all the proper adjustments so you can put it in gear and just go.
So the driver all gets to choose the radio then, huh? Because yeah. Radio, no, they know which one's driving.
Exactly. And the thing is, this facial scanner constantly monitors you. When I was shooting a video with this car yesterday, I was in a good place to do it. So I took my eyes off the road over to the right-hand side of the car. And after about 3 seconds, it started reminding me, keep your eyes on the road. I mean, $36,000 vehicle, power liftgate, power moonroof, 33 miles to the gallon out on the highway, all-wheel drive system, probably the best, as a matter of fact, all-wheel drive system outside of Range Rover. Yeah, you can tell. I'm a fan, but just you get so much vehicle for the money with Subarus, and their reliability record is just as good as Honda's and Toyota's.
Now, Jerry, I took your advice from last week. You were reminding us that there were so many manufacturers right now. I think you quoted you correctly in saying that you'd never seen such rebates that the manufacturers are offering. And I took your advice, and I'm the proud owner of a brand-new 2019 Highlander today. Now, it's got more gadgets on it than I ever imagined. You were talking about it's got this lane change thing. You can set it and take off down the road, and it will maintain your lane. That's cool. And also, this is new to me, this cruise control that it reads the car in front of you and will keep you within so many car lengths, however much you set it. And it'll just, you come up behind traffic and it slows you down.
That's how you keep from getting a ticket. Yeah. You get behind somebody that's going
to
really
thinking
fast.
I go to Dallas this weekend and I can pretty much just go to sleep and kick back. And maybe not. But.
That's pretty close. I mean, I agree with you 100%. Adaptive cruise control that keeps you the same distance from the car in front of you, no matter what happens in front of you, is amazing. And just such a joy. And I tell you, Toyota does a good job with that, because a lot of the cars I drive that have adaptive cruise control, when the car in front of you speeds up, the car is slow to speed up. So it takes a while to catch up to it. Toyota does a really good job with the settings on that, so that the acceleration kicks in. And I mean, if you're a certain number of car lengths behind the car in front of you, no matter what happens, you're going to be that same way. The lane keep assist is a nice feature, and Toyota does a good job with that. Some of the cars I get in that have that, it sort of ping pongs you. In other words, if you got your hands off the steering wheel and it goes to the left, and then corrects itself, it corrects it too far back to the right. And then you kind of keep going back. You look like you're driving drunk, but you're not. And Toyota does a really good job with all their features. Congratulations. I'm proud of you, man. That was a great choice.
Oh, I love it. I absolutely love it.
So, Jerry, we're running out of time, but what do you have on CarProUSA.com?
We have an alarming – we've got several new reviews up from since we talked last week, but an alarming story under news at CarProUSA.com about red light deaths, people running through red lights, and it's a AAA study. And this is a problem that's getting worse in America. Two people a day are dying in accidents because someone run a red light. So, you know, we kind of got to be careful with that, and then we'll have a story a little later today. Some of the things you were just talking about on your Highlander that annoy people. These things, that new safety features that annoy people, and we're finding out now that a lot of them are just turning them off.
Yeah. All right. Well, Jerry, we want to remind people you're on from 11 to 1 every Saturday, and thank you for coming on. We'll talk to you next week. Can't wait to see what you have.